In Safari, we're probably used to having lots of things popping up on our screen, whether it's cookie messages or adverts or subscribed newsletters, all those sort of things that get in the way of browsing the internet. With iOS 18, Safari has got a new feature called Remove Distractions, which does exactly what it says on the tin. I'm going to use my website as an example here, and as you can see at the top, there's a section for collections of quick tip videos. Imagine that's a pop-up advert or a subscribing to your newsletter type situation, you want to get rid of it. On the address bar at the bottom, you're going to press onto Web Page Options, and then from here, you're going to tap onto Hide Distracting Items. At this point, the address bar will change, and it will encourage you to select a distracting item. I'm going to tap onto that collection section at the top, and you'll see that the iPhone is clever enough to recognise that's a distinct part of the web page. Tapping on the Hide button does this really cool animation, like it's blowing away like confetti in the wind, and then that part of the web page has gone. And you can do this with more than one item per page as well. If I tap onto one of my videos here, and again go to Web Page Options and Hide Distracting Items, I can tap to select the headlines at the top, I can remove the description, I can remove the video if I wanted to as well. Any element of that page can be removed. And doing this will then make them disappear again, that lovely animation. Of course, if you change your mind and want to bring it back, press on Web Page Options again, and this time go on to Show Hidden Items. You'll get a little prompt, and then it'll put the web page back to normal for you. This does usually work on repeated visits to websites, it will remember what you've hidden, but if the content changes regularly, like if it's an advert that gets reloaded, sometimes that will slip through the net. But this is a really nice feature for browsing the internet in peace and quiet, and it's also really good if you want to get a screenshot of a web page, but you don't want certain elements on that screenshot. I think this is actually a really interesting feature in iOS 18, and I spent the summer exploring the new operating system to find out what's new and what's changed, beyond the headline features like those dark mode icons and the new control center. If you want to see what else your iPhone can do, and spoiler alert, there's a lot, I've written an ebook in the link below. It's called 100 Quick Tips for iOS 18, and it will guide you through what your phone can do in friendly and easy to follow language, so you can impress your friends with all of the new features in iOS 18.